and welcome to ISTV English News. I'm Subala Kangabam. Let's see the top stories first. Former Prime Minister Atal Bihari Vajpayee's ashes immersed in Imphal River. Normalcy returns to Manipur University after 85 days. Usual functioning resumes. And role of mothers of Manipur indescribable, says Speaker Y. Kenchan. And now the news in detail. Former Prime Minister Atal Bihari Vajpayee's ashes immersed in Imphal River. The processions and condolence meeting were organized by BJP Manipur Pradesh. Works Minister T.S. Biswajit, along with many BJP workers, received his ashes at Imphal Airport that were brought by BJP President K.S.H. Bhavananda and Secretary Administration K.H. Sarat Kumar. Later, a procession was taken out from airport till Kashampat, past Mayailambi, Pishumthong, Singjamai Chingamakha, Civil Secretariat Office and converged at BJP Office. In a program held at City Convention, BJP President K.S.H. Bhavananda handed over the ashes to the Chief Minister N. Biren. Ministers, MLAs, senior leaders and top officials of government departments attended the program. Governor of Manipur Dr. Najma Hepatullah offered floral tributes to the portrait of former Prime Minister Atal Bihari Vajpayee. Governor Najma Hepatullah asserted that his political career was built by Atal Bihari Vajpayee.
We should pay tributes, हम अपनी श्रद्धांजलि अटल बिहारी वाजपेयी के चरणों में रखते हैं, मगर सही श्रद्धांजलि, the true spirit of gratitude and श्रद्धांजलि would be when we try to follow his path, the path of democracy, true democracy, respect for people. Tender heart. He was a true American, a true Indian. His name itself says Atal. And I think throughout his life, he believed in his commitment. He remained Atal. And in his passing away, he will become Amar forever in our work, in our commitment towards service to the nation, what he did throughout his life.
Chief Minister N. Biren said his loss is a great loss for the nation. People must try to follow the path led by the leader in order to bring development in the country. Normalcy has returned to Manipur University after 85 days today. The development came after an agreement between the Ministry of Human Resource Development and Manipur University community. It may be recalled that MUSU launched the agitation demanding removal of VC AP Pandey on May 31. Musa Muta and other student bodies joined the movement, adopting various forms of agitations, including general strike. Classes and administrative works of the university resumed after a prolonged break. The university community resolved to withdraw their agitation and brought the academic atmosphere of the university back to normal after the Ministry of Human Resource Development assured that the fact-finding team will start probe into the case with a former acting Chief Justice of High Court of Meghalaya, T. Nandakumar Singh, and a former Vice Chancellor of Tejpur University, M. K. Chaudhary, as members of the team. Speaker Khen Chan has asserted that the role of women in the state cannot be praised enough. The speaker was speaking at the inaugural event of Singdamai Imakai Thel today. Khen Chan appealed to the women folks to continue to undertake steps for the welfare of the society. He stated that the women vendors in the state are able to bring up their children to be successful persons and at the same time play a pivotal role in bringing about the beloved society. The speaker also asserted that the government has been taking up steps for the welfare of the society. Mayor of Imphal Municipal Council L. Lokeshwar, Corporator of Ward No. 15 T. H. Bankim Chandra and Corporator of Ward No. 16 T. H. Ilija were among those present at the inaugural event. A man was drowned to death around 10:30 last night. The deceased has been identified as Bonsen Chingamkam, 23 years, son of C.H. Biren of Udipo Pachaspati Lekai. As per report received by ISTP News, Bonsen was sitting by a pond of the locality along with his friend Lawembam Tomba, 25 years, son of Lawembam Ibungo from the same locality. Later, Bonsen got into the pond to take bath but he drowned. The locals rushed to the spot as Tomba informed them. They then informed Manipur Fire Service as they could not find Bonsen in the pond. A team of fire servicemen arrived in a short while and searched for the body of Bonsen. After a hectic search, they found the body around 12 midnight. A team of Imphal police has picked up the body and kept it at the RIMS morgue for autopsy. A dead body was also found near Simplex Company at Jiribam Kunol Lamba Sorok Khongsang under jurisdiction of Jiribam Police Station early this morning. Identity of the deceased is yet to be established. Police have initiated investigation. The first state-level open folk song competition was held at GM Hall, organized by MSU today. Former Dean of School of Humanity, Manipur University, Soram Sanatomi Devi, President of MSU, Manjit Sarangthem, and Secretary of Manipur State Film Development Society, Dr. Hamom Naba, were among those present at the event. Speaking on the occasion, Manjit Sarangthem said, "The rich art, culture and tradition of the forefather is the identity of Manipur." He stated that the event was organized with an objective to revive and preserve the priceless gifts of the forefather.
Lamdam sida orukliba narol sida mamalebak mazati ramdam bo nushi ba masak khangna mamalebak lati ramdam bi kathok pa gi chilem gole na kabak to gi chama do sino no gi ni samna ko gum si gi miro le thanari asugum lo wat do kathok sing si gi marakta harpi ba khlak gi na sing sida puina tamna energetic gi ba youth sing sida magi sansom nationalism ma di belonging ness ki dum ba chilem ka na hona na ekui ipai pushing na ekui wadan thambiram ba dugum lo kunungi saisaklon sing dugo kunungi sek saida sing amukona na hona namasi harukli ba miro sing sto sa khangan ba dugo no your manipur gi campaign gi sarugum moina ngasi amsuna sugum da bachim phol da gi koi folk song competition asi an ba state ke level li tha da pangok pa dum da ba competition asi pangok sagadam ni
folk singer Lorembam Dagavati, Gose Maitai and Guru Ruben Mangshaba were the jury members of the competition. As part of the national level rally organized by Trained Nurses Association of India, pressing their various demands, Trained Nurses of India Manipur State Branch took out a rally from the association's office at Udipo Kumanthimlekai till Indian Medical Association Hall in Lamphelpat today. Speaking to media persons, Secretary of the Association P.H. Rani demanded the government to provide the pay and allowances to nurses in the state at par with the central nurses to regularize the nurses working in contract basis. She also urged to provide the rights of the nurses working in both government and private hospital.
As a nurse patient, as you say, community public health, as you are going to be present, like what you matum in a subsana machine from the government. I do think money for the year, I got the ahamba, post my amma so vacancy later. As he's humans and view vacancies, you regular your system and in view, Marie Lena Botoritina, my gay as he does Supreme Court order, as he Mapumpan and Apira Kani have a safe with his other.
President of Lamjau Apunma Maira Paibi Lup Y. Ibeni speaking to media persons at Manipur Press Club has lamented that appropriate punishment must be given to S. Gandhi of Kokting Kuno and his followers, owner of the workshop who brutally assaulted three young boys on charges that they stole properties from the workshop on August 7. She said the accused should be put in jail as well as compensation along with medical treatment should be provided to the boys. It may be recalled that the incident happened on August 7 at around 7 in the evening when the villagers came across the workshop and his followers beating up them at Langang Ching at Kokting Kuno. She alleged that it was an attempt to murder them. Moreover, the boys are in a trauma state at present. She appealed to the authority concerned to look into the matter and help the boys return to their normal state.
Kariumba sing kunzas in the Kambiram Dagadibu Angang has it see the gata later when he ever Angang has it up, she am the cheap puby was there. I don't get my dear, like I home when I am not satin and white. I do dear, I call you Makata for that. Hide you walk your hang even the bar, Gandhi I there. I call an angazi long toga, a more than a hang a gazoo. Masi a monotone, Kadodia by the minor. I don't believe, but since the body and the Tadu figure looks in the coin hiding is it.
Inhabitants around Pumlan Park Club took out a torch procession rally against the proposed shifting of Sangai Habitat to Pumlan Park at Arong Kuno in Hianglam constituency last night. The rallyists chanted various slogans demanding to save Pumlan Park and the means of livelihood of the inhabitants. Sky Hospital and Research Center has signed a memorandum of understanding with the state government to provide the benefits of Chief Minister Gi Hakshel Gi Tengbang and Ayushman Bharat scheme to cardholders of the scheme on August 15. The memorandum was signed between Chief Minister N. Biren, Health Minister L. Jayantakumar and Chairman of Sky Hospital L. Shyam Kishore at CM Secretariat. The chairman said that cardholders of the two health schemes will get treatment of heart diseases free of cost at the hospital. The facilities include treatment of heart attack, heart failure, heart valve diseases, birth heart defects, palpitation, pacemaker implant operation, coronary angioplasty with stent, open heart surgery, heart valve replacement operation and coronary bypass surgery. President of Manipur State Panchayat Parishad MD Abdul Latif alleged that development cannot be brought in the villages due to the untimely sanctioning of fund to the panchayat by the government. Speaking to the media persons at Manipur Press Club, he further added that 10 years have been completed since the establishment of the 5th panchayat. The panchayat has been taking major role to promote economy for the villagers. He appealed to the government to sanction the funds timely and support them in working relentlessly for the welfare of people.
Amabu oirabasu, amabu oirabasu, state na pukchen chengna panchayat pu thabak pangthok haningdra badi panchayat sing luina muthat piraga state na suk na paishin birabasu panchayat mihut chingidi state ki khallaga kathok chare sira haibagi wakalon phawa khanjarabani panchayat ki damak pibirak ba shantham dadi apan ba ayet pa yaudana matamcha na thadok piduna makhoi su mikhan da thilnar ka kajrak pa miyangi mihut nina miyangi apam ba thabak kharadi pangthok pa ngaman biu
Sairingba Singhi Apunda Lub, Manipur, Sal observed its 8th Foundation Day at Lamyanba Shangnin. Former Minister Bijoy Koijam, Jilla Parishad Member of Imphal East, Seram Niken, Bishnupur Center Secretary of AMIC, Thingbaijam Swaran Kumar and President of Sal, Ngairangbam Munindro, attended the observance. Sal's 9th production, written by Doneshwar Konsam, Nura Ibema, Ushilu Yadrava Imit Asina, written by B.J. Panji Mayum and Punshini Aigi Sahekna Thallaba, written by Yumnam Devjani, were released on the occasion. As part of the observance, lyricist Sanglakpam Achau Sharma, music composer Tongva Thangjam and singer Sagosem Bishwarup were honored on the occasion. Nehru Memorial Club under the supervision of Imphal East Upa Adakshya and member of top Nauriya Jilla Parishad Khetrimayum Tama, Pradhan of top Dashera Gram Panchayat M. Surbala and other ward members began to repair the work of top Awangleka Iril Mapal Road. The repair work was initiated after the authority concerned did not pay heed to repeated requests to repair the road. Electric transformer at Mothati Maino village in Technopole district remained unrepaired since it broke down in September last year. Secretary of the village, Kering Anal, speaking to the ISTV News, said the villager had been deprived of power supply till date since the transformer broke down. According to our Morin News correspondent, Sanjoy, said village chief and the villagers have raised the matter to the top officials of power company, including sports minister Letpau Hauke. However, it has not been translated into action till today. He appealed to the government to repair the transformer for the convenience of the villagers.
Government dashu minister dashu koi the complaint tau jagre adu mokoi na jeng bi balagtri adu wo handak she na koi na government na koi na ma jeng pai pang bi raga na koi jeng bi o hai bi she koi jam wa jare koi khun motha village hai bi she jam wa jabni koina sarkar na koina yeng bi ra di hai bi se koina appeal tau ya bni
Shilema Training and Cutting Center Kojuman in Oinam constituency has been able to generate self-employment opportunities after the state government provided 31 sewing machines and conducted 4-month training program at the center. Speaking to ISTB News, Secretary of the Center, Landhoni Laima, stated that the center reached the level after MLA of the constituency provided the benefits of the welfare schemes for women under the state government. And before we wind up the top stories once again. Former Prime Minister Atal Bihari Vajpayee's ashes immersed in Imphal River. Normalcy returns to Manipur University after 85 days. Usual functioning resumes. And role of mothers of Manipur in indescribable, says Speaker Y. Kim Chan. Thank you so much for joining with us and good night.